The Embraer C-390 Millennium is a medium-sized military transport aircraft designed and developed by the Brazilian manufacturer in the early 2010s. The heaviest aircraft in Embraer's lineup performed its first flight in February 2015 and entered service with the Brazilian Air Force in 2019. This video will highlight the top features of the C-390 military transport jet and go over the customers that have ordered it thus far. So, let's get started. The first thing to know is that it has a fairly high payload capacity of 57,320 pounds or 26,000 kilograms. In terms of size, the Embraer C-390 Millennium offers a higher payload capacity than other medium-sized transporters, including the Lockheed C-130 at 42,000 pounds or 19,090 kilograms, and the Antonov AN-178 at 39,600 pounds or 18,000 kilograms. The aircraft can carry heavy tracked and wheeled vehicles of up to the aircraft's maximum payload capacity. For capacity, the Millennium can accommodate one of the following: 80 troops, 74 stretchers and 8 attendants, 66 paratroopers, 7 463-litre master pallets, or 6 463-litre master pallets and 36 troops. Powered by two International Aero Engines, or IAE V2500E2 turbofan engines, each producing 31,330 pound force or 139.4 kilonewtons. If that engine name and number sounds familiar, it's because it's in the same family of engines used to power the Airbus A320ceo family of aircraft. According to Embraer, the jet engine was selected for its resilience to dust ingestion, particularly when compared to propeller tips close to the ground, which are susceptible to damage. Embraer also chose the IAE V2500 for its efficiency under normal conditions. The jet has a fuel capacity ranging from 50,700 pounds to 77,160 pounds. This equates to 23,000 to 35,000 kilograms. The upper capacity is made possible with three auxiliary fuel tanks. Finally, in terms of performance specifications, the C-390 has a maximum takeoff weight, or MTOW, of 191,800 pounds or 87,000 kilograms, and a maximum speed of 533 knots or 614 miles per hour or 988 kilometers per hour. One of the missions of a military transport aircraft is to supply air cargo during various missions. Thus, automatic release of cargo in flight is another feature of the C-390. Whether it's a strategic cargo load with weaponry and supplies or humanitarian aid, the aircraft's ability is tested through the in-flight release of cargo. The Embraer C-390 is equipped with an aerial delivery system, providing remote and automatic cargo release at low and high altitudes. The aircraft is capable of low-velocity aerial delivery with single and multiple Type V platforms. Using the aircraft's Container Delivery System, or CDS, the aircraft can drop a maximum load of 22 skid boards. And finally, for low-altitude parachute extraction, or LAPES, the maximum load is 22,046 pounds or 10,021 kilograms. Another selling point of the aircraft is that it can be reconfigured in hours. Military transport aircraft generally serve a wide range of missions, from search and rescue missions to aerial refueling and transporting of troops and weaponry. Military transport aircraft must be ready for whatever is thrown at them. Embraer claims that the reconfiguration of the C-390 Millennium takes as much as 3 hours to complete. The faster reconfiguration time is aided by the aircraft's Advanced Cargo Handling System, or CHS, which is designed with software-controlled cargo locking systems, enabling quick, easy, and safe reconfiguration whenever required. This reconfiguration can be done in-house, and there are no specialized tools required. Built-in features that made quick reconfiguration possible include tie-down grids and rings, a heavy-duty restraining system, roller trays, cargo guidance, and restraining systems. For example, the cargo floor can be reconfigured from a flat space to a roller configuration with a quick flip-over capability. The CHS features all the tools and accessories required for cargo loading, restraining, and offloading. Heavy tracked and wheeled vehicles can be restrained with the featured tie-down grid of rings with up to 25,000 pounds of restraint in any direction. Additionally, roller trays, cargo guidance, and support systems are part of the CHS. Finally, in terms of selling points, Embraer notes that the C-390 has a multi-mission capability to perform more with a single aircraft. With the ease of reconfiguration, air forces can optimize their fleet performance. Such versatility allows forces to buy fewer aircraft and different kits to enable a wide range of missions. Missions include the following: advanced cargo handling, aerial refueling, high and low speed, ground refueling, airdrop capability, search and rescue, aeromedical evacuation, and finally, aerial firefighting. The CEO of Embraer Defense and Security, Bosco da Costa Jr., states, "It's the only true multi-mission platform. All the C-390s that come out of our production line are capable of all the missions. It means that you don't need to buy one aircraft to do air-to-air refueling and then another one to do cargo, for example." While the C-390 sounds fantastic, it's still relatively new and is still carving out a market for itself. You can see the C-390's customers and quantities ordered in the chart here, which is current as of late July 2024. The launch customer of the C-390 Millennium is also the largest in terms of number of aircraft ordered. Unsurprisingly, that customer is the Brazilian Air Force, which has received 6 examples of the C-390 from Embraer. With Embraer being a Brazilian plane maker, it makes sense that the country's military and government would want to support a national company. We can also imagine that a lot of the design and development would have included input from the Brazilian Air Force. With Brazil's military, the aircraft are primarily used for transport and aerial refueling missions. The acquisition for the Netherlands and Austria appear to be a joint procurement deal. Breaking Defense reported that the first of 5 Dutch aircraft would be delivered by the end of 2027, with the forces planned to replace its existing tactical fleet beginning in 2031. It would give them plenty of time for transition. The jets will initially be stationed at Eindhoven Air Base, and the deployment of the first 3 jets is planned for 2028. Austria settled on the C-390 as its choice replacement for the C-130 Hercules back in September 2023. The deal for 9 in total was finalized at the Farnborough International Airshow 2024. Both air forces will also closely collaborate on training and logistics and be perfectly positioned to partner with other NATO C-390 operators. As militaries around the world modernize their air forces, there should be rising demand for the C-390, particularly as older transports like the C-130 Hercules are retired. Of course, the C-390 faces competition from aircraft like the Airbus A400M and Lockheed Martin C-130J. So, we'll just have to wait and see how the jet performs in terms of sales. What are your thoughts on the capabilities of the Embraer C-390 Millennium? Let us know in the comments section. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.